My lecture is about production of black soldier fly in Ghana. And now some of you don't even know anything about black soldier fly in Ghana. And so why black soldier fly in Ghana? That is the question. Now, if a lot of you want to find out that during the last Christmas season, the price of all kinds of meat just went so high. And that was because the cost of ingredients, the input in feed making, went so high. Especially fish meal and soybeans. He got to extent that there was no soybeans anywhere. And so the price doubled within 4 months. And so a lot of poultry farmers were in trouble. Some closed down, and then one poultry, a private chicken, went as far as 5,000, 7,000, and something that never happened. But we have something that the Oyibos have ready to replace fish meal in the feed for poultry and in the feed for fishes. Yesterday, I told the wife of the Vice Chancellor that I was engaged in another workshop. And that was in a farm outside. And you cannot imagine that that man's farm had a lot of these black soldier fly rats all over the place. And they usually told it to me. So, one day I visited his farm and I saw the Cooper case littered all over. I said, what has been in your farm? Millions of naira being wasted. He said, man, I said this thing you're seeing are millions of naira. And so yesterday after the lecture, he marveled because we used it to feed his pigs yesterday and come and see how they were surrounded for it. We used it to feed his layers. And I said, well, because now we place fish completely with black soldier fly now. And I wouldn't know why it has not taken up in Nigeria. Because even in Ghana here, they produce it in large quantities. And like you know, a lot of Oyibo have established their companies for black soldier fly lava in Ghana, but not in Nigeria. But you know of a woman that is working assiduously now with IITA to establish one in Nigeria. And I'm part of that business. So when it's done, we'll be producing black soldier fly lava in large quantities in the country. But I also want us to do this in our country. I'm waiting for you. I'm saying for you.
Hi everyone. My name is Rosanne. I'm an agripreneur. Here I'm doing fly farming, black soldier flies. And come, let me show you what that entails. This is gold, brown gold, brown light gold. My journey began in 2013 when I started questioning the usefulness of being in a job where you're supporting young and vulnerable children, but once the critical period hits when they want jobs, there are none that are available and their formal employment is really very much problematic. So I took a step out of formal employment and came to explore the area of enterprise development. I knew that pigs was a niche that I could come into, and so I set up the piggery unit with the aim of demonstrating how profitable pigs can be. I wanted a unit that is really well, you know, that does not waste anything. And so what happened is that I went to Ethiopia to get information on how to process the pig manure into insect farming. But Ethiopia told me that there are better ways of making the insects, and they introduced me to the black soldier fly, which became actually more very well connected with the pigs, because then the pigs would have a continuous source of protein as well as manure in which you can now use for the farm. The black soldier fly will give you from 500 to 1,500 eggs per female. And those eggs, we incubate them in a substrate of waste that we have prepared so that you can get the eggs and hatch them. It takes 3 days for the egg to hatch. And once the egg has hatched, the small larvae start eating the waste immediately. From the hatch period, it takes about 14 days, going through 3 different stages, Insta 1, Insta 2, Insta 3, and they gain weight very, very quickly. By about Insta 4, it is time for you to harvest them as feed. That means that you can actually feed them already to the chicken and to the pigs. Fish also do very well with black soldier flies. We always leave 10% of what we have grown as larvae in order to continue perpetuating the colony. And those ones take another 2 weeks, they get into the pupa stage and they emerge into flies. Once the fly has emerged, it takes about 10 days with a diet of water only. And during that time, it gives you eggs that will then now begin the process all again. According to research, black soldier flies are eaten in cotton equal if not superior to in cotton to fish meal and soya beans. There is a general movement to move more towards the sustainable sources of protein, and the insect sources become very, very aligned to that. We have also competition between cotton sources. If we look at fish, fish is eaten by humans. Fish is used as a source for animal feed, and if you can be able to separate and leave have direct streams, then also the cost of feed production will also come significantly down. And the amount of resources that go into creating a kilo of black soldier flies is actually significantly lower than the amount of resources that go into farming, say, 1 kilogram of fish. So again, it is about sustainability, it is about responsible consumption and responsible production, and it is about also care of our environment. The fact that we are using waste, or what is seen as waste, to become a valuable input into the process is also a very big opportunity, because through the black soldier fly farming, you're converting it into high-value product, thereby holding the value of the product into the economy for much longer. So that is also pretty good. There's also quite a lot of opportunities in youth and women employment creation. We have a working team of about 7 people, 50-50, women and youth. And during peak times, like during harvesting, we usually take in extra labor as casuals, and thereby also contributing to the local community that we live in. This unit is a learning unit, and so we've been engaging the local community, and they've embraced a lot on the black soldier fly farming. It is very profitable for them to do this and have it as feed for their chicken in the homestead, thereby getting nutritious food for their families, as well as surplus, which they can then sell and improve their household incomes. For anyone who would like to venture into black soldier fly, I would say go for it. I think this is the direction of the future. Making valuable resources from small inputs, looking at things that are looked at as waste and turning them into higher value products, and products that are within the cycle of nature, and thereby ensuring that lots of chemicals and things like additives are avoided in the production process. The end result of our process is actually organic manure, and that also then goes back into the farmlands, and the farmlands become much more productive and much more pest resistant. There is an element of healing of the soils, and so it makes the whole thing quite healthy, quite sustainable, and also good for the pockets. And this has been my story in the black soldier fly space, contributing to climate smart agriculture. And I'd like to know your story on what you're doing in the same space. Tell me your story.
The fish meal that making the cost of poultry feed cost can now be replaced with this black soldier fly larvae. which is almost exactly at the same crude protein level. And so with that, I'm going to start my lecture. Can we have production of lab sugar? So I've already given you the introductory, the reason for plant sugar plant, so move on. So that's the plant sugar plant, the plant sugar plant itself. I brought it here so that some of you can see it. That inside this net, that the plant itself. Maybe when we finish, you come and look at it. So it's the one that produces that lava that we saw. Move on. So this is the lava. And our interest is in the lava, not the fly. So some people, like I'm going to show you an attractant, demonstrate of how to make the attractant that will bring the soda fly to lay the eggs. So some people will stop at just producing the lava. Why some will continue to recycle? So it gets to the fly, depending on your capacity and the income you have. Move on. So I say, why farm plant soda fly? And I've given you the reason. One of the reasons is that why so many people, especially the promoters of vegetarian diet, no matter how they are to say it, meat remains the major source of animal protein in the whole world. And that's what we know. But somebody I quoted also said the same thing. And so, meat production has been on the high side because of high cost of feed ingredients, especially for the animal protein resources. And that is fish meal in particular, as far as Nigeria is concerned. And so, because of that, one day we recommended 35 grams of animal protein per person per day. In Nigeria, Nian and Jodhubri say that the consumption level is at 8 grams per person per day. And that's why I always quarrel with people who say, don't eat bread, don't eat meat, don't eat. We are not even eating enough. Not to talk of whether you are eating red or white. We not started eating enough. And besides that, red meat has a hidden iron. I presented that in my faculty lecture that no plant protein has. So you cannot avoid red meat. And besides, the meat that has the problem that then are processed meat. And when we talk about processed meat, I'm talking of all those ones that you see that are looking so appealing in all these big shopping malls, supermarkets like ShopRite, like Rubank, all of those things. Why? Because they are pure. What we call pure is addition of certain chemicals, especially nitrates. And that's what makes it red. And that's what is an carcinogenic. And that's why you say there is not real red meat. Because all processed red meat has no problem. Has seven nutrients that no vegetable protein has. Where is my list? Okay, I'm coming. Okay, let me keep talking. So, because of that, we must go to meat. And to have meat production, we must have the inputs at cheap enough prices that will make everybody to afford it. And because last year, at least all of us knew about how the prices of all meat rose up, and then how some people could not afford it. And so, we are supposed to revert to what other countries have started doing. And what have they started doing? You will see it in this lecture. Because they have completely replaced fish meal with plant soda fly lava meal. And so, that's one of the major reasons why we are finding plant soda fly lava. And so, talking about plant soda fly lava, how do I start that business? You will see companies that have started it in large quantities. Anything what I've said here is about the high cost of soya bean. So you can pass that this. So the first thing about starting it is first about knowing the biological cycle. But let me watch through this. Just people, all I'm showing here is that you can see that animals share chicks, all animals. Maybe except ruminants. So you saw chicken, you see this one dog, all animals, they just enjoy it. So the black soldier fly itself looks so much like a wasp. But a later distinguishing factor is that it has two bands, move on, two bands of translucent segments in the abdominal region. That's one major thing you find in it. You can see it here. You won't find it in the wasp. Go on. So, okay, I will have missed this. Potentials of black soldier fly now. Number one is that because it decomposes any organic matter so fast, therefore it controls water. They eat up the manure, organic carbon, before they even decompose to that extent, that would be very offensive for them. And because of that, they control water. Two, everywhere you see them at the colonizing place, they suppress the growth of any other pest. And so we also use them for pest control. Number three is that there are natural antibiotics. Initially, when we were talking about this changing of fish meat like bottom, some people suggested maggot meat. And maggot meat was used for some time before people started looking at the absurdity of eating something produced with maggot. And that is also because maggot is also a carrier of some diseases. It's a vector. But unlike black soldier fly, instead of carrying diseases, it destroys disease carrying agents. So, you see, because the Torah says it contains natural antibiotics. Move on. Then, Jude 12:20-13 says that it suppresses Escherichia coli, Salmonella enterica, Saroga enteritis in any contaminated chicken manure. So, it destroys disease causing germs in most of the organic material. Then, it's also involved in pollution control. Because once it decomposes organic waste as fast as possible, it will control pollution. Simply because it does not allow it to decompose to that extent that odor is released. Then, it's of no pathogenesis, that is, animals that are taking it. The PSF larva is not a vector of any disease, but no disease has said that. And because of that, it's a demonstration of low pathogenicity. Go on. So the decomposing of organic waste, I've said that. And then there is bioconversion. And then when we say bioconversion, if you have a heap of organic manure, or even reduce stuff like this, and you introduce this black soldier fly larva into it, within a short time, you see decreasing just like that. And then, move on. And of course, I say it is an important animal protein resource. And that's why we are doing this lecture. Because we want people to start using it. You can imagine the farmer I told you, his son had a lot of meat, and they were throwing it away instead of giving it to the pigs and the poultry he has. So I said the best place to start is to know the biological cycle. And like it's shown here, you will see that this adult, like his death, his lifespan is just between 5 to 8 days. As soon as the female lays there, it will die. And the male will just fly around after some days, it will also die. So their lifespan is just 5 to 8 days. And so the man has a larva. I show them the small one, which you still come and see. The smaller ones, it molds, each of the molds gives rise to the one we call another instar. So you have first instar, second instar, up to the fifth instar. After the fifth instar, the next is the one we call pre-pupper. Is there, you see? The pre-pupper stage. But the time we harvest, when they have maximum protein content, is this fourth and fifth instar. Move on. So I'll be talking about the life cycle as I do. So this is just to show you the duration in each of the life stages of it. The egg stays for 4 days and it hatches into the first instar. lava stays for 2 weeks. In this spring, you have 15 to 30 days. But actually, the normal period is 2 weeks. The reason for 15 to 30 days is when they are not fed well. If they are not in an environment where they are feeding well, they will linger before they get to that. And even when they get to that pre-puberty, they will be stunted. That is, they won't reach the normal size it's got to reach. And so it's important that they are welfare. Then the pre-puberty stage lasts for 7 days, and the puberty stage for 10 days, sometimes they will still stay for 2 weeks. And then goes into adult. The advantage into adult is so fast, not up to 5 minutes. So move on. So the first thing about farming black soldier fly larva is to know the male and female. Now, the like is stated in that one, the male has a more rounded tail, while the female has a more pointy tail. Okay, so the developmental stages. I've already mentioned that the eggs, you know, where they lay eggs, they lay eggs in plants, trellises. And because of that, we have some in the captive management, we have some our own structure that we call eggies, in which we bring them to lay eggs. These eggies are just like high plants. I'll show you. Can you move down? Move, drop down until I get to you. Are you sure you're not moving up? I said down. You are going up. Keep moving, fast. Get to like what? Okay. So these are the eggs. And what we have, can you move down it one more time? So this is what we make, and that's why I asked somebody to bring me carton. So this carton is like an improvise, where you don't have the one I just mentioned. I will still show you the one I mentioned, but because it's the one handling that. But if you don't have that, you just plant like this one, about 5 of them, and that kind of pin that is used in repairing shoes, you put it in between to create that kind of space where you lay them. But if you don't have that, they like this pattern too. So if you put this pattern, you use rubber band to hold it, and then you place it in the attractor that we're going to prepare now. We are going to prepare an attractor. So if you place it there, it will come and lay it. Can you move down a little more? This is the plant I was talking about. So when you have this plant, if you put that nail like something, pin they use in preparing on each of them, at the tip of each of them, it will create small space in between, and they don't get to lay it. Okay, get back to where I was. And so that's about the egg. So this egg, like we said, takes like 12 days. No, go to egg. Down. Move now. You are not in egg. So the egg is just about these eggs. You don't see them. You only see them like the one I showed you when they are in cluster and clinging to a little yellowish in color. But if you now view them in the microscope, you find out that they are roundish or oval in structure. So the one black soldier fly will lay 500 to 900 with the average of 500. So, during the early time, we don't do much management. But it's in the larval stage that we do management. Because the larval stage is the only stage where the black soldier fly larva feeds. And when they feed voraciously. And that's because that's the only time they eat. And they eat and reserve it for all of the other life stages. Okay? And so, during this period, I've already mentioned they move from one tower to they get to the sixth not good to me. Bring me back to God. So during this period, you see, I wrote management of the lab. During this period is when we treat them. At the first instance, what do I do? Okay. Now, there is a kind of container we use in collecting the eggs. Like I said, I'll show you how to make the aquarium. Then, when you get that eggs, I show you, you will perforate a kind of container like this one I have.
We usually use something to create a hole in this container. It will be roundish, it will be rectangular, but you make a hole. In this hole you make, you cover it with a mosquito net. So you use, let me say, to stick it to this place. So that way you collect it, you now scrape it on top of the stone. Remember I told you, even the lava, the fresh pizza lava, you can't see it easy. You can only see it also microscope. And so, as they hatch in that bubble, they turn into this your content. This your content will contain the affected. And that the affected, that we call it hatching shower. You are giving them so much. So we usually use brighter scatter hatch at 30% and then water 70%. You mix it together, put it in the container, cover it with the perforated leaf that has a zinc-like screen on top, so that as they hatch, they drop it from here. Now, the one we use is really black soda fly fan. Is the 5 day old of that one. So once that you place that in, you have 5 days. In the 5th day, they will have developed into an extra that you can see. So you now collect. When you collect, you can't. Because you wouldn't want to have what are they told you about when you have a high density in a container, they will not do well. It's the same thing here. If you have so much in a container, the container we use for the lava development, we call it labyrinth. And in that labyrinth, it's usually 40 by 60 by 17 cm. In that labyrinth, it's expected that the labyrinth of that size should contain 10,000 of the lava. Now, counting that 10,000 will be, is it 20 days job? And so we don't count. When I was in Netherlands for the training, what they were doing and what they taught us is that you count like 100. And then you use a weighing balance to weigh the 100. If that 100 gives you like 5 grams, you extrapolate. So if we say 100 will give 5 grams, then 10,000 will give what? So you do the mathematics. Whatever it gives you, that is the quantity you will make instead of counting. And you put it in that label. Is that okay? So, I said we start with a 5 day old, right? So, move on. Can you go back? That 5 day old, the quantity of feed we give is usually 15 days of organic food for 12 days. And so this 15 kg of organic food, you're going to divide it into 5 parts. You give the first 5 of the 1, second 5 of the 5, third 5 of the 8. Okay, so that's the lava we're talking about. And this is what we're now using to replace fish. Move on. The optimal conditions for lava development. I've already told you about the feed. The second one is the climate. The temperature requires 24 to 30 degrees centigrade. In Netherlands and many other temperate countries, they use climate control chamber to maintain this temperature. That's in our country. Our country is just too good for it. You don't need any climate control chamber. Our temperature is normal than required. But it also needs changed environment. Changed environment is that they don't like, and lava state they don't like light.
If you put light anywhere they are, they start running out. And so, it's important to don't put light. Then, for Pupa. In the case of Pupa development, you remember, okay, move on a little. Move on. This is Pupa. The Pupa state. When we get to this state, at the pre-Pupa state, it will be like this, but it moves. That's the difference. The way it becomes Pupa, it will not move. It becomes Pupa. So, this Pupa state, we don't do much on it. Go back to the others. So, the only thing that the Pupa state requires about two preferences. The only thing we do is to transfer to the location page. That's the, I will show you the place. Usually 60 by 40 by 12 cm. And this Pupa state is always preferable in the time. At that time, they require that environment. And so, management as a latter is to start the place in a damp environment. I'll show you that's what we're using where my student is teaching me. Move on, let me show them. Keep moving, keep moving. Move, move, move. Keep. Okay. This is the cage for people. So all this, the place you are stuck with it, you push it into this chamber that is covered with that cloth. And then you sweep it up so they will make that environment for it's actually 2 weeks. Then on the 12th day, you connect the this one we call lockage. I think we have left. Get back to where I was left. Just for that. Okay. So the only thing you do is to change them. Then in the adult stage, okay. When the pupa emerges, their mating is usually done in flight. That is area mating. And that's why we use this. This thing we call it lockage. If you come close, you see a lot of the flies inside here. This is where they normally meet. Because you allow them to fly around, so they lay while flying. And that's why we call this the lockage. So as I said, I want to show you a lot of the designs of the lockage. Move on. Keep moving. In so many farms, they have different designs. Move, 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 move. Until you see something like this. This one example. Each of them will always have this corner, like you have it in my own. This corner. Because it's a connection between the lock gate and the tap gate. Move on. This is another guy. Somebody might decide to construct it to plant a mosquito net instead to still give you the same result. Move on. This is the time we have. All of these black spots are black soldier fly we are about to do. Move on. This is another type that somebody has. So I want you to notice here this light. This fly, as at the time they are fly, they love light. You get it? So I said at the 12th day of the book of the patient. We have. You can see this one. And the question is, you connect this one to this one. This one is supposed to be on the stand by this one. So you bring the two close to connect. Remember, the Pupa doesn't like light. The adult likes light. So as soon as the adult emerges, it will see light in this place. It will fly. So as many adults that emerge, they will fly into this place. And so this takes place. You get it?
Yes.
So,
during that time you're expecting the baby is when you're going to do those things I showed you that I call eggs. The one you make with the carbon, the one you make with plants, you never want. You place it inside its neck on the floor of the neck. And the reason is because as they mate, the female will look for something to make eggs. So you put the attractant that will attract the female and put the eggs on top of it. So the female will be attracted to that female and it will make eggs. Like I said, after the female has made eggs, it will die. Okay. So, in the housing, this is a part that does it. You can see how you can stamp the place in large, like if I have this as my glass program line house, I can have up to 10 minutes here. Yes, because you stamp, you can imagine what you say if you have like 10,000 units of this. Right? So, it's a big part. So this is another type of somebody else's stuff. Move on. Now change this. Change this. So in starting there are two major ways to start. It's either you start by going to buy the plant. Oh, okay, don't worry. Oh, because I never got to. Or you can do collection from the wild using an attractor. If you go to Brothers of Sensitivity in Mount Sinai, you'll see a number of microbes attractors. Because these attractors, when you prepare it, you must place it close to where there is organic matter. The organic matter can be poultry waste, it can be feed waste, it can be refuse from place close to where it is. Because the insects have a center to make their offspring survive. They must have food, since it is only the larval stage that they feed. And their only food is organic material. So they usually lay their eggs close to organic material. So if you're starting, you do your own attractant, which I'm going to show you how to prepare. You prepare it and then give them at the best the flies to come. So, the ingredients for preparing it are having a rice bran, a little sour water fruit with strong smell like banana, like mango, like pineapple. Well, move on. So, you prepare container. The next is to prepare containers for rearing of the hatches. I've already told you how to prepare it. That plastic you perforate on top, put a seed. Move on. Managing from lava to pupa, I think I've said this. We start feeding and they start growing. Move on. So the next thing is products that we get from black soldier fly. Now the products are many. There are three key ones that people want in the production of black soldier fly. Move on. This one, kind of. You have the lipids, that's the fat, the proteins, and then the titrate. These lipids, I went to three big factories in Netherlands, one in Belgium, and in all of them, they all sell this product. The lipids, those of you that are used to shea butter, it looks exactly like shea butter. And they sell it to both pharmaceutical and cosmetic industry. And then you have the protein, that's the one they sell to us. This is the one I was giving you. Because at the protein farm, I'm showing protein farm in Netherlands. They gave us this, and then the fat, I don't know where I go, fat. But this one is the protein. Then,
You have the title also. The title is that it's a skeleton. That, because normally that is one of the things that not too digestible to the person. So they now extract it and they still sell it. They change the title to another form they call phytosan. Move on. So this is DSF lava oil, that's what I'm doing. Move on.
So this 0.68 is a very luxurious spin oil.
and it is for management. So the people that police, the man that police the first time he job, come and say they will do something to step the fact that the bag has to be like it. Okay, move on. Am I now this company, Service Life, they are all good, they are not used to anything. They are all good things that they combine the kitchen, the titosan, and sell the pharmaceutical industry. I want to show big companies in US, America, Thailand, Netherlands, we are waiting, Belgium, we are waiting, that are into cereal, like this produce, they produce over 20 tons a day. In that Netherlands, they have two companies that produce steady food. This other one is also for fruit. The only difference is the eggs at the end of one. So that one, when we got there, they were producing 20 tons also. Then they wanted to abuse this one. So we met them building a very massive structure. Then they said they want to produce 40 tons. Move on, move on. So the animal protein. So because of all this, look at it, I said, I want to read this. He said, an international team of researchers led by him in the year 2018 in South Korea and in the US. This is a team research work, a kind of research on searching. Explore the use of black soldier fiber in the diet of product as a potential delivery and in regard to the effect of the meal on immune functions. I reported that PSFF meal improved sick weight gain, boosted immune responses, and increased survivability of the pet against Salmonella Candida experimental infection. So the animals were infected with Salmonella Candida, then after giving them the black soldier fiber, they found out they can't find it. So, because of that, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, after investigation of PSF, has named the oil and the rose glass, has recommended amendment of Association of American Feed Control Officials, ingredient definition of dry PSF. Okay, good. So this, our own company, this company is situated in South Africa. Very big, very massive. The people visited this company when she went to South Africa. In fact, she came back with their meal, which she had asked one of our students to use in the research work. Their own meal, they call mark oil for their oil, mark meal. Because even the that organic money you use in rearing the lab is highly nutritive. So you also sold as fertilizer to the soil. So this company sells it as mark soil. The people sell the soil used in rearing them another. So move on. So you can see the I showed this other one. I also visited this farm, Protein Farm. This is the one I said, as at the time we were here, they were building another massive structure for 40,000 ton production. Move on. This is the Protein Farm, the place where they take us to. Founded by this art. We met the person himself, but unlike the people in Protein Farm, this one we were so surprised. They didn't allow us to go into their structure. All that I know of it is what I read from the internet. But they didn't allow us to go in. Even though they welcomed us for table space, but they never allowed us inside. Move on. This is Eritrea, Canada. Another company producing black soldier fly lava in Canada. This is also massive too. I've not been to this one, but I've heard of it. Okay, go on. Then the world's largest insect farm is the white insect farm. Now, this one
is not really into Black Soldier Fly-By. They started with cricket. They started with cricket for them. Now this protein farm is doing both Black Soldier Fly-By and also cricket. Okay, I think move on, let's think and conclude. Yes, I'm concluding. So why are they seeing this Black Soldier Fly-By? They have this tendency of crawling out. And that's why when they crawl out, you won't see any money on their body. But so the time we are rearing them, we use a kind of soil called copropits to surround them so that they don't crawl out. But once you're through with rearing them, and at that time, you now bring them out, shake off all the. And the soil farm, they have shakers. As soon as they point, you say that this shape, they will start crawling out on their own, and they will be manure. So these are the. Let me go to you, get what I say. Which stage is this? Okay. So in conclusion, I say, I believe strongly, somebody here is interested in setting up a Black Soldier Fly farm. And I want to believe we also have investors here. And I know now wants to be an investor. And let me also say that before the last day, the former Vice Chancellor, I have a number of visitors that came to me on this matter. So the last one that came, that's a Frenchman that came. So then the current Vice Chancellor was then the Vice Chancellor Academy. So by then I've written my letter to the Vice Chancellor requesting for land and want to set up insect research center. And we approved it. And they gave us the land just beside the primary school. And so that time the French man came, we visited the Vice Chancellor, we visited all of them. Both the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academy and me. And they all agreed. We should start. But then it was Professor Kami in the room. And she said, I'll come and sign everyone in the university. I was telling her, there will be a sharing for me. I said, my next step first. And then I'll come to a sharing for me. And I said, thank you for listening. They asked me to share.
To get what they want. And they also get to any name
to ensure that it is safe for women. You understand? And so, the absurdity about using mammals is there. No doubt about that in Nigerian context. And that is also because we don't have the capacity or the resources to make what we need safe. Because I was in Sudan, and they were standing on 20 million. In fact, the lot of people they kept in my was as big as this, they said. I will meet and meet and finish it. If I come back, we have built another one. It was on the last day of my departure that I now saw that this meal was coming from Paddle. I said, hey, I'm a meal. And that is because of Nigerian Paddle. And so, the truth is that, like I mentioned, the matter from house is a business time. So if anybody wants to stay away from you, that is his right. Especially for the fact that we in Nigeria don't have the capacity of making what we need to say. But this one is not to resist time. This one has been proven not to be a vector for any disease. Thank you.
Thank you very much for the question. And I want to ask, this last year line has, is adoption in the country kind of widespread or even organized? You know, we are asking that in agriculture, we have a problem of really poor people introducing Nigeria in the early 80s, something like that, in the 1970s. To control an insect larvae or cassava. Before you know it, then what you do, it can be based on the way that it can control the cassava survival. Suppose these last of the life is now being, you know, back to the price of places, is of the place in Nigeria, but now you're not divided by the people there. What do they get out of hand?
In this case,
so what, how will they handle it? That's one. Then number two, I want to know whether we can also do the same, you know, this platform line, bring it here in Nigeria, only I'm not sure the one that did in there. How successful can this be with the use of the biggest?
Okay. Number one is that black soldier fly lava is native to Nigeria. So it's not something you're important. You know, we were clear about the case of Unipop because it was important for the people to control certain pests and then it came. But this one is native to Nigeria, even more than in the Netherlands or any other place. You get what I mean? So it has been here, just like that one I say, just that we don't know what it is. For instance, me, first thing I landed in Netherlands, I never knew I would see it in Nigeria. Only to come back from Netherlands, I found out that my people did not feed my chickens with this medicine I kept. And the medicine grew old. So much British old. So I now went to throw it away, learn to go. I saw this thing, I said, can you pick it? I picked it up. It was exactly the one because they gave up the pack like that one from Netherlands. They said, if you put it into your box, you don't go home because they catch you at the airport with your hand. You know? So I carried that one down there. A friend from Unicorn came. I was doing research and collected almost half of it for me. So I started with the other half. Only to now find it in my backyard. Exactly the same. And at that time I called my VA instead. I was supervising. He was working on instead to Apple. But he was working on Apple. That's termites and African power. So I called him, I said, do something for me. He said, what? I said, get a bag of medicine from any farm, all these people making apple. Keep it, let's see what happens after 1 month, don't touch it. He did it, and he saved me at the end. He brought it to me, I was shouting. I called another man to give it to him. That was a question. I said, do this. He did it, and he got it. Then I back, telling them, instead of buying so much food, you have it in your pocket. In fact, that is what made me that position as a council member in our Nigerian Institute of Animal Science. Because when we were contending for that position, we were three other professors bigger than me. But I have what I want to bring to the table. They don't have. So every day, I was pushing out information on how we can convert our organic money that is available to the country into something useful to the society. So I kept using this app until everybody started changing towards myself. Later, when I won, the elder man with our president came and said, "Is this brother there? You are welcome. Every day you are visiting." So my duty is to go around telling them this thing in your mouth is useful, and that is the reason I sent my direct to the manager and sent me to you yesterday to train. One came from investor. One came from Kogi State University. One came from Port Harcourt. The other one came from Federal Ministry of Agriculture. We were together in the farm. That's why I was not going to be a listener. And so I prayed them, and they said they're going to write a proposal, national one now, to help us and our people follow us. Because we want to establish farms in the future police business. Okay, well, I didn't do that. Maybe you know you're supposed to even play with the contractor. Then I will come for that. We'll play for contractor. No, you are my friend. Okay, he's my friend.
Okay,
thank you.
Thank you, bro. So, Prof, I want to really know first, this plan, social plan, Lava, how the coordination of the family is not orderless, need order.
No, I
said that is one. Second, I really need to come back again. I want to really know what it takes from the support.
The five units you need in a black soldier flying lava farm. Number one is the waste receiving unit. Then number two is the waste treatment unit. So the waste receiving unit is where you are likely to proceed from. Because as at that time, the waste has not been treated. So as soon as it, and it's usually outside the farm, we don't allow it to be inside the farm. So as soon as it gets into the farm, the equipment has started, the oven is gone, and everything. So you said concerning what it will take, it's not about the same thing about the cost, right? Yes. The same thing you are saying is what the chief of staff, so I have it ready, that's what I'm trying to say. Because the chief of staff of this state, he has a very big farm at Agulay, very expensive one. And he has called me to prepare him with the food. So I have a ready one, including the cost. So for those of you that want the cost, I have it ready.
Question number four. Please, the first side question here. Thank you.
My name is Eden Koma. Being here is like an eye-opener, and it's beyond what it was about. So, but as you were talking, I get it flowing through my head. When the time you talked about that, they can introduce you to feed the chicken and their fish. I'm looking to the part of fish because I'm into fish and fish like excites me so much. So, but on the point you talked about, there's some research I saw in 2018. This is a very updated research that they introduced it to the poultry birds to control certain diseases. That means the birds are exposed to certain diseases, and they gave them the black soldier fly.
So, can that also be applicable to the fish?
Exactly.
Okay, so you tell me that you said yes. So now, what about if a fish is exposed? Because now, we know that in the wild, there are a lot of toxins, the river nitrite, and it also is a lot of heavy metals. And most researchers are now going, how can we reduce the effect of this toxins on the fish? And I like the idea of this plant fly. Because I'm asking, because students can find their research and we can use that to reduce a lot of problems we have with fishes. Is it possible, maybe you introduce a toxicant to the fish and then we incorporate this black soda fly in their feed to feed them? Can you reduce the effects?
I don't think so. Because if it is a toxicant to have introduced, you won't expect black soda fly to be filled with germs. Disease-causing germs. You want to use it to control like marine water fish. The only thing we can do is to introduce it in radius bombs that we carry into that so to already decompose and destroy some of those germs before they get it.
Yes, Prof. Thank you very much. From the results you say, the people have had a short period to transit to the next stage. And you showed us a certain product that we go to prostate process from the three you mentioned, then the oil and all that. But you didn't say much about the process, the processing process. Because if you collect the pupa and you don't feed it, use it up in your farm for feeding the animals, you lose that, except you know what to do.
Okay. Let me not go into what I don't do. The one I was taught, that's the one I'm going to see. That is about the production and the processing. To the extent of this, that will be used, incorporated into poultry feed. But I was not exposed into the processing of the fat or processing of the chitin. So this is the one we went to because in Netherlands, we met with this man, Skelton, the one that most of the fish farmers use is fish feed here. We met with him and he said, he has, I'm trying to answer your question. He has a big market, huge market in Nigeria. And that if us that are delegates from Nigeria can give you quality black soldier flyer, that the cost of fish feed in Nigeria will drop. So, that is the reason we started answering the name Quipa. We answered the name Quipa and died. Pointing insects, whatever in the platform. So, I said that to say because you said that the problem with Nigeria is that if they give you this product today and maybe the protein content is 22%, tomorrow they might bring the same product and the protein content has reduced to 18. So it varies. And pay somebody in production. They have a formula they use in producing fish feed. And that formula is already fixed. So all the quality of the ingredients they want should be fixed. So that every time they bring it, they just run to and know they will have the same quality. And so the production level they talk about is how to dry this. They have a kind of some have solar, whatever they use, dry it, they use. They just place them very short while, not prolonged drying. Very short one. All that they needed is for it to dry as well. Thereafter, they now bring it down and then allow it to dry on that sheet for some time. Thereafter, they blend. When they blend, they test for the quality. That is quality in terms of nutrient composition. So when they get the nutrient composition, they will write it. Because in their own, they normally write whatever a person has. So, the package. When we were in Wagnegan, we now found them that Wagnegan University and research center. They were producing both the fish feed and the livestock feed. We met them, they were packing it to 25 kg with the black soldier. Even in that way, Wagnegan and also Thomas More University, then we also have grasshopper farm, big grasshopper farm. And that also got me interested. So I would say that the aspect I learned is from production to use as feed or fish. I can go into that problem. Thank you, I think I'm done. I'll take the point on this. And the ratio of producer to what I want is the one. So whatever you use in measuring, you also use the same measure for water. Then if you have like the one I have now, it's moist already. So it may not be exactly what you want. If it is dry, rice bran, or maize bran, it must be ratio 1:1. There are sometimes this may be some getting moist already. So, you use your discretion to know what to do. So, when you have added, let somebody give us water. The normal thing is to blend it, as if it is banana. You use blender to blend it properly. So after blending, you now pour it and mix. So the attractant must be watered. Is that what I mean? Yeah. So after adding the blended fruit, you now add more water. Remember, the time you need it to ferment, it was not working, right? But the day you are now making it to use as an attractor, add more water until it is really water. But this one, I'm supposed to add more of this. Did you make the rule? Is it what you want? Yeah, that's why. Or you did not put the fruit. So it will be watered like this. When it is like this, you now prepare that what we call egg. Egg, that is yellow, it's either used upon or those plants back in the back. So I'm going to do that. Yes.
your youth. The idea is that the length you will cut will go. If you are doing it, I don't advise you to use this kind of pattern. You know those thicker patterns that have bigger holes? I didn't do it well, it must be a very poor length and size. Then, you now. So, you can put this up to 4 on this. You can even stack more on top of it. So, assuming we have done it, when you carry it, the place you are going to place it will not be close to the feet. Because when the smell of this are carried back, and they come, they might think it's the tree. They will fetch on the tree. And when they fetch on it, and lay on those small, small holes on the back of the tree. It will be difficult to spray them. So, wherever you are putting it, it will be far off from you. So, you just place it somewhere. And that is far from the object. And allow it in 2 days' time to start checking. You will see cluster of the eggs. So, that's the one you now spray up to that screen and put it. That's it.